Om Shanti, a greeting of peace to my sisters and my brothers. Thank you for giving us the privilege of hosting Remembrance Sunday here in the premises of the Brahma Kumaris. We are honoring those who gave their lives to be able to give us freedom and to be able to live a life in which there is justice and democracy. Peace is something deep in everyone's heart, and this is because the original natural state of every human being is that of peace. I know that when the mind is peaceless, then in that state of peacelessness, many other things go wrong in our words, our actions, our behavior, our relationships. It has rightly been stated in the preamble of the Charter of UNESCO. Wars begin in the minds of men, and the defenses of peace lie therein also. And we deeply believe this, that if we can create an awareness of peace within the self, then it is this peace that is going to exude out and impact everything that I'm involved with, everything that I'm engaged with, everything that I can offer to the world around me. First and foremost, to myself and my family, my colleagues, but it reaches out into the community and therefore into the world also. Peace is actually the natural state of the human spirit. And we have a very beautiful expression that comes in the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita. And it says, Shanti, tumara swadharma hai. Your original religion is that of peace. And if I can remember this, then yes, at all times there would be peace within my awareness and my behavior. It is important to remember the things that have happened in history. And yes, we've been through not just the two big world wars, but in this period of peacetime, there have been so many conflicts across the world. And today we're at the precipice of perhaps what may be a turning point in history yet again. Our prayers, our thoughts of peace are very much needed to support our brothers and sisters who are across the world facing situations of absolute desperation. I believe very much that the vibrations that we share can actually make a difference. Through the pandemic, we would have many people send us messages on the phone or on email, and they would say, so-and-so is dearly loved and is unwell, is critical, or has passed away. Please send vibrations of peace in God's remembrance to my friend, my husband, my brother, my sister, my mother, whoever it was. And sometimes we would get feedback and they would say, the vibrations that you sent were actually very healing for the individual. And we saw a big turnaround when that happened. And in fact, there have been experiments in the USA in particular, where they experimented with the healing power of prayer, of silence, of meditation. It has been found that if we have thoughts of peace, we can actually shift the vibrations of the place that we are in, but also we can send out vibrations to all those who are in need. Peace is something that we can generate within ourselves. Peace within means that I also open the door to the treasure of love, of truth, of dignity, of respect. Sometimes I wonder, what is the essential problem that we are facing in the world today? And very often it comes back to fear. Fear of loss of property, of status, of possessions, of a beloved one, of my dignity, many different types of fear. And all of these stresses that come out of fear make us take steps that are not normal. Fear leads to abnormal behavior, in which instead of the genuine compassion and goodness that lies within the human spirit, we express aggression and violence. How can I remove this fear? My spiritual experience tells me that if I go back to the awareness of my true identity, the identity of the inner being, the being within that I am, then in this awareness, my respect for myself and my love for myself is stable and consistent. It depends on nothing outside at all. And so no one and nothing can take away that respect and dignity from me. But I have to come back to that understanding of my spiritual identity, the being that I am within. And in that awareness of the inner being, the being of light, and connecting with the goodness that lies within, the compassion and kindness and love is able to manifest instead of the fear and aggression and violence. It's a lesson that's a very important one for us, that when we love ourselves, then we can love our neighbor also. As the good book states, love thy neighbor as you would love yourself. How often is it that I remind myself that I truly have permission to love myself? I'm not talking about narcissism or ego, but that state in which I know what my inner core values are, and on the basis of those core values, I'm able to respect myself and maintain my own inner dignity. And of course, the times when I move away from those inner core values, then that's the time when I lose my self-respect also. And then of course I'm seeking respect from the world out there, and that may be available or it may not be available. And so what I need to do is to spend time with myself, learning about my core values, strengthening those, and knowing that peace lies within, love lies within, joy and truth also lie within. Connecting with myself, then I'm able to express these and share these with others around me. When I can love myself, I can love you. When I have regard for myself and respect for myself, I'll have respect for you. Each one is my neighbor. But also, we are responsible for this planet, this beautiful pearl in this ocean of darkness of the cosmos. This is how the astronauts describe planet Earth. The beauty of this planet is the water. And so can I extend my respect to all forms of life and even the very elements that have created this beautiful home of ours. And so today, I'm remembering those who have left us, whether through war and violence or whether through illness, but also thinking about the freedom that we have been blessed with and the hope and definitely the vision for the future of a world of peace, of truth and justice, a world of love. When all of us hold this vision together, then surely the power of God's love and the power of our cooperation in this task of renewal of this world can surely take place, and it will happen, and we will see a beautiful world come back to this planet again. Thank you and namaste. I bow to the divine in you. Om Shanti.